Hello, I'm Mike, and in this video, I'll show you an AI lead generation and follow-up sequence that is killer, personalized, and will grow your email list exponentially. Just look at all these emails I recently sent out to all attendees of a session at a conference I was presenting in Athens recently on AI tools. I got a 98% uptake in people signing up to my email opt-in because I promised that they would get a personalized reply. Let me show you now the sequence I set up in Zapier and show you how you can do it too. We'll get started here by building an interface that's kind of like a fancy form that can collect your email addresses. And we'll start from scratch here as we can build a shiny new interface for people to opt in to get this template. So we'll go ahead and select form here, and then we can choose a form. Well, I'm going to actually create a table, and that's where the email addresses will be stored. Okay, as you can see, by default, we're collecting email addresses, but we'll add another field, and this is going to be the full name field. We'll also go ahead and add one more field just to make this highly accurate, and we'll enter a company field like so, and add that to the form as well. Now that's done, it's important to go back to each one of these and mark them required. So now you can see on our Zapier interface, we need an email address, a full name, and a company for this automation to work. I'll link this form up down below so you can test it for yourself, and also you'll get a personalized response from me along with this template that I'm showing you how to make. Okay, so far with that created, we can click to the live page, which is here. We can type in something really quick to just see if it works with the full name, Mike R, and the company, like so. Click submit, and hopefully it will go through and say, yes, the form has been submitted. Now we can go back to Zapier. We can get out of this. We can look at our tables over here, and you're going to see the table is currently called page. I'm going to rename it to lead gen demo, and then we'll go ahead and take a look at that table, and you should see, yes, what we just submitted on the page has been recorded in the table. Now we can do cool things like automate with this data and send a personalized reply immediately to the person who just signed up. Let me show you how. Let's go back home and create a zap here. This is where we'll be able to automate everything that comes in. So we'll start with a trigger right here, and you'll see quite conveniently, Zapier includes the ability to trigger an automation from interfaces. So let's do that, and we select an event. You'll see here form submission created. We select that and we go to the next step. Now with interface, we need to select the interface. This at the moment is called new interface, but I don't like that. So I'm actually going to rename it to lead gen. Go back here, refresh results. And we've got lead gen ready and available. So for the page now, we also select page, and then form, we just select course, the form that is included. With all of that information configured, we can test the trigger. Yep, you can see my email address, my name, and my company all there. Now, because I want this to be highly accurate, let's submit the form again. Some pretty honest information there. Submit. We'll go back to our lead gen demo table, and you'll see indeed all the information I'm submitting here is being collected. So a great way to collect email addresses, even if you don't have an email marketing provider. Let's go back in and find a new record, and we should find that new form submission B, yes, with all my accurate information, we can continue onwards. Now here, if you do have an email marketing provider, for instance, I've got Kit, I can go ahead and choose to add a subscriber to a form. Then I just need to click sign in and make sure to connect my Kit account. It's just a one-click connection here. With that done, we can then configure this. Now I could set up a custom form, but I'm going to do the main landing page here. Email will link back to the form submission that we just got. And of course, first name can link back to the name. We can put them into the opt-in sequence, and we can add any custom fields that we've got for Kit. Of course, you can use any email provider, and Zapier link with most of them. Okay, next up, it's time to get into detective mode, and I'm going to go and choose a webhook here from Zapier Pro. This is where I'll be able to connect to Perplexity to research the person who just filled in my lead gen form. Now, it's a custom request, note that. And of course, I'll link everything I'm doing in my community down below, including the full Zapier template if you want to go ahead and clone this yourself. We'll click to continue, and for the method, we'll choose post. Now we're going to need to make sure to put the Perplexity URL here to call. We want false for data pass through. Next up for data, we're calling Perplexity's own Sona model, which searches the internet, asking it to be precise and concise, and saying, find out what you can about, and this is where we put in these fields again. So we need to, of course, select the user's name that was filled in earlier. So I'll put that one in here, from, and then this is where we'll go ahead again and put in the user's company, which is just here, and summarize it. This will allow Perplexity to feed back to us and give us a summary on what it discovers about this user. Authorization, we put in bearer and then our PPLX API key, along with content type as application/JSON. With that done, it's on to ChatGPT to write a personalized and slightly humorous email to the person who will opt in via our Zapier interface page. Before we do that, though, let's test this out and we can see, yes, the information is populated. Find out what you can about Mike Russell from Creator Magic and summarize it. Let's test this step with Perplexity. And there we go. Very quick. The data is out. And look, we can actually see citations here. Founder of Creator Magic, platform on helping creators to leverage AI in their workflow, and loads of other info, probably more than I'd care to admit, is there and available from Perplexity. So with this done, we go ahead and add a step. And this time we're looking for OpenAI's ChatGPT, which is available right here. As an action event here, we're going to choose conversation. And I'm using my ChatGPT account, which is LinkedIn. Here, as my prompt, you'll see I say write a short, friendly, informal email to. And this is the point where I need to put in the data to populate again. So again, we just go in down here and find the name of the person we're writing to, which is for me right here, to Mike Russell, and use a fact or two from this info about them. And this is where we pull in the Perplexity response. Again, you'll find that a little bit lower down on the custom request in webhooks. And you'll see the response is right here. Make the email slightly funny and sign off from Mike Russell at Creator Magic. Always include a link to the Creator Magic community. For the model, I'm going to go ahead and choose ChatGPT 4.0 latest. Now for the assistant instructions, I'll tweak that a bit to say you're a funny, helpful assistant. Write a short, friendly, informal email. Never use markdown or formatting. Never include title or any other instructions in the replies. Only the body text of the email. And always reply from, and I've given an example of the kind of signature I'd use to sign off my emails. With that done, I can click continue. And if I like, I can click test step. And let's scroll down. Yep, I can see a response. So now I just need to send this using Gmail. Let me show you how easy that is. Before we add the final step in, notice we started with a Zapier interface where we collect the user's name, company, and email address. We add it to our email marketing system, Kit in my case. Then we use a webhook to call Perplexity, and I'll actually rename this to be Perplexity for clarity there. We chat to ChatGPT to write a personalized email. And finally, we connect to our Gmail account with Zapier like so. And here we don't want to do any drafts. We want to instantly send an email using my own email address. In 2, we use that email address that was dropped in earlier on via my Zapier interface page. The from field, I'll select my own email address. From name, of course, that's going to be me. I put in a custom subject here. Again, if I want, I can put the user's name into that subject as well using form mapping. Body text should be indeed plain. And for the body, we'll just pull in the email that ChatGPT has written, which is right here. Everything else is looking fine. Let's go to continue and test this step. Okay, now I can go to my inbox and see if my AI agent has received my information via the Zapier interface page, processed it, and replied to me with a slightly humorous reply, having done detective work on finding out who I really am. And what do you know? Here it is, sent to me 0 minutes ago. Here's my Zapier lead gen template, and let's read this out. Hey Mike, I just wanted to drop you a quick email to say how much I'm enjoying Creator Magic lately. You've somehow managed to blend 25 years of radio chops with this slick AI wizardry. It's like if Obi-Wan Kenobi hosted a podcast and taught robots how to produce audio. Seriously though, I love how you're championing the idea that AI should boost creativity, not bulldoze it. It's refreshing to hear someone with actual experience and Adobe certification cred lead the conversation. Your YouTube channel's been on point, especially the episodes where you dive into AI tools without turning us into Skynet. Keep doing your thing. I'm learning tons and laughing along the way. Catch you on the next pod, Mike Russell. P.S. And then a link to my Creator Magic community. I mean, that's crazy. That's a better follow-up email than I could do myself sitting down in front of a keyboard. And now I can do it en masse to anyone who signs up using my email opt-in form. This is a really cool automation, and I can't wait to hear how you'll be using it. Let me know how you'll be using it down below, and maybe let's discuss this further in the community. Join, there is also a link down in the description, and let's share ideas and maybe enhance this automation a bit. Like I say, I used it at a recent conference, got a 98% uptake, and also created some really nice personalized relationships as a result of people replying to those AI-generated emails and then starting a real-life human conversation with me. And I'd really appreciate a like and subscribe to this channel as I do stuff like this weekly. Oh yes, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now. You should watch next. Thanks.